So, all investments on the job convert people who have kind of general skills into people with some specialized skills. Now, question, what you mean by specialized? That's going to be answering your question. You can distinguish the different degrees of specialization. You take a narrow degree of specialization, your skills are specific to the firm, sometimes called firm-specific investments. Okay. You familiar with that? Most of you familiar with that? And all it means is what it says, that the investment raises your productivity in this firm, which is any firm, but doesn't raise your productivity in any other firm. A very strong version, but there may be things. You learn the culture of the firm, and maybe, once you go to another firm, you have to learn an entirely different culture. You learn who are the capable people at your firm. Go to another firm, you have to learn. So let's say I be here, I know who are the smart people worth talking to on the faculty, and who are worth avoiding, right? And in any job, you learn those skills. Those are firm-specific. There's firm-specific investment. Now, if it's firm-specific, by definition, it's only useful in the firm. Right, so let me write down various distinctions. And we'll go. Now, why is this pointing outward? We have industry specific and occupational specific. Somewhat different. As I said, firm specific, you raise the productivity only in the firm. Okay. Industry specific, let's say it's equally useful in all firms in the same industry. So you learn automotive skills, you can apply them at any automobile company. Okay. You learn how to teach at a university, you can do it at Chicago, or you can do it at Stanford or any other. That would be industry specific. Occupational specific, well, you get your training as a doctor, and that's true as long as you stay in medicine. If you take your medical training, try to become an engineer, it's not going to be very useful to you.